So I used to love eating cereal. Then I had to completely stop because there's so much sugar in it. With Magic Spoon, it has zero sugar, only four net carbs, 13 grams of protein. So it's low carb, no sugar, gluten-free, soy-free, grain-free, and it's keto-friendly, guys. It works for everybody. Check out the link below and grab Variety Pack today. And be sure to use promo code GenIron5 at checkout to get $5 off any order. Or go to magicspoon.com/GenIron5. At Magic Spoon are so confident in their product. If you don't like it, you get your money back, 100% guaranteed. No questions asked.
I was never going to be a man's physique.
Didn't have much of an off season.
I like his physique better.
I'm always very energetic.
I will have to put me as one of the greatest.
Mr. Olympia was won by the back.
You're married, right?
I am.
So a lot of old school bodybuilders, right, they used to say having a girlfriend or a wife is like kryptonite for a bodybuilder. So what is the secret to being in a relationship and still being a pro athlete?
I mean, I think having Melissa is probably the most beneficial thing I've had for my bodybuilding career. You know, and I think case in point here can be Tampa Pro last year when I didn't have Melissa there. I had a mental breakdown. You know, I really couldn't handle all the pressures and the stress being by myself. And, you know, I was running around trying to get food and, you know, worrying about doing this and worrying about doing this, as well as, you know, when you're alone in your thoughts too much, you're looking at social media and all these things. And, you know, I really got in my head. But when I can have her and someone to kind of keep me grounded, and also someone that's a second set of eyes that is used to seeing my physique on a daily basis, you know, she sees me every single day in real life. So, you know, even with her relaying that information back to Patrick, my coach, you know, he takes her opinion in her eyes as number one in terms of respecting her opinion. So a lot of times he foregoes even talking to me being like, how do you think you look? He just messaged Melissa and be like, hey, what do you, how do you think he looks? And she knows. My wife is also a top tier pro, you know, so she's, you know, an Olympia level figure competitor. So, you know, she knows what good bodybuilders look like. You know, her brother is Chris Bumstead, who's won the Olympia, you know, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm married to Chris's sister. So,
oh, I see.
You know, it's kind of all in the family, right? So it's, you know, she's absolutely been, you know, a godsend for me in terms of my bodybuilding career. And being a competitor herself, she completely understands the trials and tribulations that we put ourselves through. And, you know, she's great with helping out with everything I always need. So, you know, having her for with me in Tampa and Texas, I mean, I know 100% I wouldn't have been as good at either of those shows without her. So, you know, I know for some people it can be difficult. And, you know, when you're at this level, especially if you have someone that's not really as immersed in the industry, or not even in the industry, just in that lifestyle, it can be very difficult to have a mutual understanding, you know, and people can be like, well, why do you need to spend so much time at the gym? Why do you have to do this? Why do you have to do this? You know, and I think that's very, very difficult. And I, you know, I sympathize with anyone that, you know, has to go through that, but you need to find yourself a partner that's understanding and supportive of your goals. And the same thing goes, you know, if it was the other way around, they need to understand, like, if they had a job that was a regular 9-to-5 job and they got a promotion, it's, they're going to be working in a different city 2 days a week. It's like, okay, you know, how are we going to make this work? Let's be, you know, understanding of this. Let's try and do everything we can to help, you know, and not cause additional stress to the person. It's just, you know, we're trying to all help each other out here and be as successful as possible. And Melissa has been great for that. So
I guess the key thing is they can't be selfish. Like, they have to understand your regimen, right? That's the key thing here.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, it's, you know, and like I said, I mean, you know, having her, especially, you know, when you're tired before a show and having someone to help you cook your food and, you know, or you run out of a certain food and you're, you know, dead tired or got to do your tan, you know, they can help you get the meals ready or help you do your tanning or, you know, like for me, I'm, you know, obviously can't shave my own back. So, I mean, you know, have my wife to do the monotonous bullshit of bodybuilding like that, you know? So just having someone there, you know, to keep your head calm and keep things moving smoothly. And like you said, not being selfish like that is very, very important. You know, someone that's very selfless and wants to help you succeed as much as they want to help themselves succeed, right?
That's a good point. Somebody does have to shave your back. You're right.
Yeah.
People don't even think about that.
That's tough, man. I mean, you know, it's, if not, you're find someone else to, and I can tell you nobody else wants to do that.
Well, sure. Another thing people want to know is, all right, is it possible to have some bad habits when you are a bodybuilder? Like, for instance, having a drink on the weekends, maybe smoke some, you know, smoke tobacco products or whatever. You know what I mean? Is it, can you do both or not?
Look, can you do both? Sure. Obviously, when you're talking about upper echelon bodybuilding, you know, when you talk about the chemicals and stuff involved, know, you're already putting yourself in potential harm. You know, even if you're someone that's doing, you know, very bare minimum, you're doing things that are toxic to your body in some capacity. And when you're adding things like tobacco or alcohol into it, you're obviously just adding more fuel to the fire. So, you know, if you want to be as, you know, I think one of the most important things in bodybuilding to have a successful career is remaining healthy and keeping that longevity. And, you know, you look like someone like Dexter, obviously he's an anomaly, but, you know, the longevity he had in his career and staying injury free and not having any serious health ailments is one of the things that led to him having such a long and prosperous career. Right. So, you know, I think, look, you can, I'd be lying to say that there isn't tons of bodybuilders that smoke cigarettes and drink on the weekend, because there's a ton of them that do. But I think when you're talking about having a long and the best career possible for bodybuilding, you should obviously limit those things. Look, and you don't want to be like stale Mr. No Fun. Like, if, you know, once a year, twice a year, you know, five times a year, whatever, you know, you go to a friend's birthday party, you go to a wedding, you know, you're a best man at a wedding or something, or, you know, it's your Christmas or whatever, and you want to have a few drinks, you know, you want to smoke a couple cigarettes because you're drinking. Okay. I mean, live your life. I agree with that. I mean, I'm not, you know, take fun out of life to be a bodybuilder. I think I don't agree with the statement that you need to find balance, because I think to be upper echelon and anything like that, there's absolutely no balance. I think that you need to be tilting the scales towards your profession. But, you know, to find a little bit of those moments in there where it's not going to be detrimental to your career, and it can give you a little bit of time to step out of that normal, you know, monotonous routine for you, I think it can be beneficial for your mind state. So limit these things, obviously, and, you know, try and do it at the moments that matter to you, and not like drinking every weekend just for the sake of having a drink. You know, like, I limit these things to, okay, I've just done the Olympia, I placed seventh place, let's go out and have a few drinks, let's go out and celebrate. Okay, you know, it's my buddy's wedding, you know, we're going to have a few drinks. Like, this is, I save those moments, and it makes them a little more enjoyable for me, because it's not every weekend, you know, it's, I cherish these moments a little more. So that's my recommendation.